Today we are going to highlight a fantastic Tinkercad Sim Lab robot, and then we're going to print it and bring it to life. So let's get cracking. Today we are going to start from the HLMT23 tag. Once again, you can get here by searching HLMT23 or simply type bit.ly/new-HLMT23. These are updated every day. There are so many awesome projects that are shared. Of course, when you do share something, I will give a reaction. Now today we're here because of these awesome robots created by ZDP189. Of course, he set them to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. We're going to play with this one right here in just a minute, but I do also want to highlight, when you click on these, you can hit view in 3D. You do have to wait a moment for it to load, but once it's done, you can hit simulate and check it out. So notice here it says S for start and E for end. So once this little guy loads, I can hit S. And bingo, you can see how the mechanism works. You can hit pause, you can slide it back, you can check it out from any angle. How cool is that? Once again, because it's set to copy and tinker, you can also open the project up and modify it to make it even more epic. At the moment, there are 5 robots. Robot 3 does have an issue, so it's not posted. You can, of course, find them through this search, but I've also created bit.lys. If you type bit.ly/robot5ZDP, it'll take you right to this project. Of course, make sure you give a reaction before you hit copy and tinker. The project loads zoomed in, but watch this. If you do Control-A and F for fit view, it instantly backs up so you can see what we've got going on. There are notes right here that say the wheel has alternate slots, so you can choose how eccentric the hub is from the driven motor axle. We also have a note right here showing that this time it was put very far from the center. Of course, the big part of the project is, can you guess how these are going to be different? Before I launch it, I'm just going to show you what we've got for differences. This one is exactly centered. This one is 1 peg off. This one is 2 pegs back. Notice 0 is center. There's 1, 2, 3. And then the final version is the one that is all the way back. Now, friends, let's take it to Sim Lab and let's do the quick test. When you see this orange, that is the geometry being calculated. You do need to wait for that to finish. There is the snap of what it looks like when they do finish. And now, friends, we can hit play. Don't forget it was S to start and E to end. Now, one of my favorite features of Sim Lab is we can pause, zoom back out, and then we can slide this play button back to analyze what happened. If we look at this from the side, you can see that the first 2 pegs, this one and this one, are about the same. They both work equally well. If we back up and check out the third one, notice it gets at an angle where it kind of has a little bit of jump. And the final one, if we zoom in, it actually flips the motor over backwards and then accidentally drives off the table. So friends, of course, this lets you play with the mechanism, but the coolest part is if you have one of these motors, you can actually print it and test it out in real life. Let's back up and let me show you the modification I would do to make that work better. Step 1 is I need to print one of these, so I'm going to do Control-D, and I'm going to nudge it out, and then I want to ungroup it. It was grouped into 2 pieces, but when I 3D print this, I want to lay it flat. I'm going to move it away from that pin. We do not need that. It is actually built into the motor. I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. Notice if you stay inside this blue circle, it's 22.5 degrees per click. If you come outside, it is 1 degree. If you hold down shift when you rotate, it is 45 degrees per area. When you're done, we can simply select it all and hit D to drop. This is a reasonable starter for printing, but I actually even want to make it better. I want it to be flat so there's no gap underneath. I'm going to do that by simply bringing out a cube, and I'm going to stretch it larger than the shape, and then I'm going to cut off 2 millimeters. I'm going to type 2 and press enter. We can see right here that it's going to make it flat. I think I'm even going to do size 3 and press enter. I'm going to switch to flat view and top view to make sure that my rectangle covers all of the shape that I want to cut. That'll be perfect. So now I can select it all and do Control G to group. I'm going to switch back to perspective view, and now you can see the entire thing is floating. If I hit D to drop, it is now flat and ready for 3D printing. I'm going to simply click Export, STL. I'm going to store it in my 3D modeling folder and call it Robot 5 Eccentric Wheel. Let's quickly hit Create New Project. Let's choose Add. And I'm going to grab that eccentric wheel. Of course, I need two of them, so I'm going to clone, tell it OK, and I'm going to auto arrange. I will allow it to rotate, and bingo, it's ready. And I'm going to choose to do Control A to grab them both. Right click, and I'm going to print this with my red filament. I'm going to use the 0.24 draft settings, and we'll have wheels for our robot in about 45 minutes. Send it to the 3D printer, and after a moment it goes to the device menu. And of course, once it finishes downloading, we can click play and monitor everything from afar. All right, so this is version 1. It is printed with the bubblegum PLA from Polar Filament. As you can see, crushing it. That is simply a couple wires connecting the motor to a 9-volt battery. So these are the wheels that I just printed. Part of the fun with this kit is it's adjustable. These simply slide out. And this lets you see that this time I made them thinner. This was a thicker version. And then we get to pick the pegs that we connect them to. So last time I did one out from center. This time I'm going to choose the exact center of the hub. You just simply slide these on just like that. Pick the amount you want them squished in. I'm gonna go right there. I am simply sliding a wire through and twisting it to make a connection. You can, of course, make yours much more fantastic. We'll move the bubblegum PLA out of the way. I'm gonna simply hold the battery like this, and bingo, you have got a fun little robot that cost almost nothing and also lets you explore 3D printing. Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to highlight a few things. If you noticed that awesome pink color, that is Polar Filament's bubblegum color. I've got it in PLA, and I'm absolutely loving it. I, of course, also want to thank ZDP189 for the awesome projects. I only showed you one. Please explore the others. Find the one you think is most epic. Of course, if you've got one of those little yellow motors, you can print them, test them, and it would be awesome if you shared results back with us. Finally, friends, I want to say thanks to everybody that support me via YouTube memberships. Of course, 3 different levels, and with any level of support, you get access to videos a little bit early. I do also want to send a huge shout out to everyone supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There's a wonderful messaging area. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you click that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.